Hey everyone, in this video I want to talk about what partial pivoting is in numerical methods and how we can apply it to a problem. Partial pivoting is the method used in numerical methods to help us reduce truncation or round-off error when solving our system of equations, and it increases our numerical stability. So, it is essentially a tool that will help us better solve our numerical methods problems. In brief, we use partial pivoting to get more accurate answers when solving systems of equation problems, and it prevents us from having a zero on our main diagonal if at all possible. Firstly, we can have partial pivoting or full or complete pivoting. Partial means we only consider and move rows within our matrix, and thereby changing the order in which we present our matrix. Whereas full or complete pivoting, which is slightly different, considers both rows and columns, and thereby changes the order in which our equations are presented and the variable order. You can think of pivoting as rotating our equations, which, if you remember, is not actually changing our matrix at all. But you may ask, aren't we just adding more operations and therefore more calculations, which will slow our algorithm down? Well, yeah, partial pivoting is not meant to speed up our program, but it will add some numerical stability to our problem and, as I said, reduce our truncation error. So, now that we know what partial pivoting is and why we might want to use it, how do we actually go about implementing partial pivoting, and why does it reduce truncation error? Firstly, let me just say that with partial pivoting, we're going to be working with the elements in our main diagonal. You can refer to this as our pivot element if you wish. As a formula, we use partial pivoting if the absolute value of our pivot element, the element along our main diagonal in our row of interest, is smaller than another element in the same column. Then we switch the rows, thereby pivoting them. Then you would continue and complete your numerical method for that row and repeat this process. Therefore, as an algorithm, the partial pivoting method is typically applied before each iteration. So, for example, in Gauss elimination problem, we would check if our main diagonal element is the largest within its column. If it is not, then we switch that with the row that does have the largest absolute element in that given column. This essentially allows us to have the largest number possible as our divisor in our scaling factor, which we commonly use to reduce rows. We do this since the larger number in our denominator will lead to less truncation errors, which will grow like a snowball throughout our problem. So, in summary, partial pivoting is an extremely valuable numerical method tool that will allow us to reduce truncation errors and prevent zeros on our main diagonals when solving a system of linear equations. I hope that this video helped your understanding of the purpose behind partial pivoting and why we use it in numerical methods. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.